Hello everyone. In the last session, we have understood how to solve the simple problems on returns. So in continuation of that, if you consider the notion of portfolio. So in order to understand the return on portfolio, we are going to calculate the all the securities expected return. We are going to calculate the all securities expected return. So in that, what do you mean by notion of portfolio? So notion of portfolio means whenever you calculate the return of the particular security, you should also consider the risk factor of the security. So you should also consider the risk factor of the security. So the risk and the return, risk as well as return, both are associated each other. We have to consider for the calculation of the particular portfolio. Okay, so sometimes individual securities will be strengthened. It will be stronger than the multiple securities. So at what time it will be very strong? If the risk is considered for the calculation of the return, then it could be easy. It could be easy to invest the money in the particular security. So here, two conditions we have to understand. So whenever you consider the risk factors, or two conditions we can easily come to know that. The conditions are, the first one is, the particular security should be having more liquidity. The particular security should be having more liquidity, and the particular security should generate the expected return over a period of time. So then the individual security may be better than the multiple security. So these two are conditions we have to understand while you are investing the money in the particular security or a different types of security. So when you take the portfolio return and the risk, first one, if you consider risk and the return, so we have to understand the conditions of the both risk and the return, then we are going to invest the money. And diversification. So diversification, notion of the portfolio also says about the diversification. So here diversification means, instead of investing the money in particular one security, so you invest in different types of security. That is called as diversification. So it it quoted by financial management contributor, it is called, don't put all your eggs into one particular basket. So instead of putting all your eggs into one particular basket, or you put it in different basket, because it may break, the particular egg may break. So in order to avoid that, instead of putting all this into one, you put it in different types of basket. That is called as the diversification of the investment. So we have to diversify the investment from one security to another security. So instead of investing the money in one security, you invest it in different types of security. We call it as diversification. Then covariance, also one of the point we have to understand in the notion of the portfolio. So what do you mean by covariance? So covariance brings the variability of the return in two securities. So whenever you consider two security, the variability of return can be found. So for that we call it as covariance. So I repeat once again, covariance helps us to understand the variability of two returns in the particular security. So we call it as covariance. So covariance may be positive or a negative. So if there is a positive value, if there is a plus value in the covariance, that represent there is a relationship between two securities return. If the covariance is negative, that represent there is no relationship between two securities return. We call it as covariance. So we do consider in the return calculation. Okay, so these are all the basic things we have to understand in the notion of portfolio. So let us find out the value of return on portfolio. So first, let us do one problem on the covariance of two securities. So whenever two securities come, so how you are going to solve it? So you take the given values in the problem, return of A and the return of B you can consider. Okay, so given values, problems on covariance. So given values, they have given values from the different security. So they have given return of A and return of B. So let us find out. So return of A they have given, return of B they have given. So return of A is 30, 20, 15, and return of B is 15, 20, 10. They have also given like probability they have also given 0.15, 0.70 and 0.15. Okay, so this is I, this is this is high securities and this is middle, average, and last one is the below average value. Okay, so the given values in the problems is 3. One is return of A, return of B, and probability for both return of A and the return of B. So here you are supposed to find out the covariance for the two securities. Okay, so let us find out. Go to the solution. Okay, so first you are supposed to calculate the expected return of A, okay, and expected return of B. Actual they have return they have given, so you are going to find out the mean value of return A and the return B. Okay, so how to find out that expected return? In that A separately you take it and B separately you take it. Okay, separately you have to consider. Fine. So here, so how do you calculate the expected return of A and the B with the help of probability? Okay, so return of A, okay, 30 into 0.15. So how much you will get? So you will get 4.5. Same thing, simultaneously you consider, you will get 14, then at the end you will get 2.25. Okay, then same thing go to B, so you will get 2.25, then you will get 14 and you will get 1.5. You will get 1.5. So you do sum of these. So you do sum of this one. So you will get 20.75. And also do it for B. How much will get? 17.75. This is called as R bar A and this is R bar B. Okay, so then you calculate R A minus R bar A. Whatever we have done in the previous session, you do it. R A minus R bar A, then R B minus R bar B. You supposed to calculate. Okay, so R A already you found it. This is R A 4.5. minus 20.75. So how much will get? 9.25. Then 14 minus 20.75. How much will get? 0.75. It is a minus value, greater than that one. Then same thing, the last one, 2.25 minus 20.75. So how much will get? Minus 5.75. Okay, so same thing you do it for another also, RB minus R bar B. So you will get the value of 2.75. This also minus value. Then, so you will get B, that is 2.25. Then you will get 7.75. This also minus. Okay, this is called as RA minus R bar A. Got it? Hope you understood. This is called as RA minus R bar A. Okay, same thing, RB minus R bar B. So then find out, at the end you have to find out P into RA minus R bar A whole into RB minus R bar B. You are supposed to calculate, okay? P probability they have given 0.15 koti dane. So find out, this is 3.82. Same thing. So you will get minus 1.18. Next, you will get 6.68. Okay, so total of this you do 1.68. You are going to get, this is called as covariance. This is the problem on covariance. They may ask you for sometimes 7 mass and even sometimes for 3 mass. So you go through that, you will understand. This is about problems on covariance. So they have given A written, B written, probability they have given. With the help of this, we are going to find out expected return of A by taking multiplication of 0.5 into 30, same thing for the subsequent, and 15 into 0.15. So we'll get 4.5, 2.5, like that you are going to get it. Okay, so you have to do it R expected return of A and the expected return of B, you are supposed to do it. So you will get 20.75, then 17.75. Okay, have you got it? So then go to the B, you do multiplication of that and you will get average of 17.75. This is called as expected return of A and the B. Then you go for RA minus R bar A. Okay, R bar already you have found it, 4.5. Okay, 4.5, then 14, then 2.25. So if you go for RA minus R bar A, you will get 9.25, then 0.75, then minus 5.75. Second and the third one is minus. Same thing you do it for RB minus R bar B. At the end, probability into RA minus R bar A into RB minus R bar B. So you will get 1.68 as a covariance. This is the problem on covariance. I hope you understood. Next, moving on to consideration of both risk and return for the securities. Consideration of both risk and return for the securities calculation. We call it as portfolio risk and portfolio return. Okay, whenever investors consider two securities, so how you are going to calculate return on the portfolio and return on the risk, and also we are going to calculate the value of R, that is correlation coefficient or a coefficient of correlation. Okay, so whenever two securities are given, how you are going to calculate the risk as well as return is called as portfolio risk and return calculation. Portfolio risk and return calculation. So on what basis you are going to calculate the value of risk and the return. So whenever weights given to the particular security, weights will be considered for the calculation of both risk and the return. So by taking weights of the security, we are going to find out the return on portfolio and return on risk on portfolio. So based on the weights value, we are going to find out. So first you take the problem. So before we go to the problem, let us take some formulas to calculate the return on portfolio, return on risk, and covariance, or you can take R value, correlation coefficient value. So first let us take the formula. If investors consider two securities with weights, how you are going to calculate the return on portfolio? Okay, there is a formula, return on portfolio, that is ROP, return on portfolio. Okay, first we are going to find out the return on portfolio. So based on the weights, we are going to calculate the return on portfolio. So return on portfolio is equal to weights of X security into X bar. Weights of X securities into X bar, two securities whenever they have given, plus weights of Y, second security into Y bar, mean value of Y security. Fine. So what do you mean by weight? Weight is equal to W. Weight is equal to, or W is equal to, weight divided by proportion. Divided by proportion. Weights is equal to weight divided by proportion. Fine. Next, after calculation of return on portfolio, we are going to calculate, standard deviation. We are going to calculate the standard deviation of particular security. So standard deviation of particular security, if you take X security, okay, or Y security, whatever, whichever it may be, or particular security if you take, or standard deviation of security 1. So how do you apply the formula? That is sigma X minus X bar whole square whole divided by N minus 1. Individual security risk you are going to find out. Okay, so after finding that, you are going to calculate the variance. Okay, variance and correlation coefficient. This is first one. This is second one. Third one, covariance and correlation of coefficient. Correlation of coefficient we are going to find out. Okay. So correlation of coefficient is equal to, that is R, correlation of coefficient, that is equal to covariance of X and Y, covariance of X and Y divided by standard deviation of X into standard deviation of Y. Whereas covariance of XY is equal to standard deviation of X into standard deviation of Y into R, correlation. Okay, if R not given, if R not given. We will consider this one. If R given, we will take it this one. At the end, we are going to calculate return risk on portfolio. Risk on portfolio, we also call it as standard deviation. Risk on portfolio. Risk on portfolio or standard deviation P. You can take it in any way. Okay. That is root value of weight x square into standard deviation x square, like that we are going to consider. We apply this formula whenever you are going to calculate the risk on the particular portfolio. We are going to apply the formula, that is weight 1 square into standard deviation 1 square plus weight 2 square into standard deviation 2 square. Okay, weight 1, then weight 2, then plus 2 into R into weight 1 into weight 2 into standard deviation 1 into standard deviation 2. We apply this formula. Note this formula. Okay, standard deviation P, standard deviation portfolio is equal to weight 1 square, standard deviation 1 square plus weight 2 square, then standard deviation 2 square plus 2 into R into weight 1 into weight 2 into standard deviation 1 into standard deviation 2. We apply this formula. These are the basic formula we are going to apply whenever investor consider two securities along with the weights. This formula we are going to apply. Okay, so first you take a problem. Based on the problem, we can understand given values in the problem. If you take a problem, they have given two security, one is X and the one is Y for the year. They have given X and Y. X securities they have given, I'll write it here. Here they have given X, they have given Y. Here they have given 2 years, 2019-2020. X value is 12%, 18%. Next Y, 14% and 12%. Okay, and they have given weight of 60% and 40% respectively. X 60, that is 0.60, Y 0.40. This is the value they have given. So we are supposed to find out first return on portfolio by taking weights, then standard deviation of particular security X and Y, then covariance, that is correlation coefficient value, then we are going to find out the risk on the portfolio at the end. Okay, so first you find out this one, the basic one, return on portfolio. In order to find out X bar and the Y bar, we have to compute the covariance value. So first you have to find out the covariance value. So you find out the covariance value for X as well as Y, then you will come to know that. I just rub the board so that you can understand. Take these values x and y. I'll write this side. So continuously we can do this. Take here. You can write from here, I think. Here 2019-2020 value they have given x and y. That is how much? 12%, 18%, then they have given 14% and 12%. Okay, they have given. So sigma rx you can calculate, then you can calculate sigma ry. You can easily come to know that sigma rx is equal to 12 plus 18, it is 30. Sigma ry return is equal to 14 plus 12, 26%. With the help of that, you find out bar value, that is mean value, find out r bar x. Rx bar is equal to 30 divided by number of years, how much it is, only 2 years. Take it, it is 15. Then you take ry bar is equal to 26 by 2, 2 years. N is equal to 2. How much you will get? 13. You will get. This is called rx bar and ry bar. With the help of this, you find out x minus x bar. X minus x bar you find out. Then you also find out y minus y bar. X minus x bar, how much will get if you take, if you consider this one? Okay, 12 minus 15, it is minus 3. 18 minus 15 is plus 3. Okay, next that is 13 and 14. 14 and 13 is plus 1. 12 and 13, it is minus 1. This is called y minus y bar. Okay, then you go to x minus x bar whole square. X minus x bar whole square you do. So 3 like square value you take it, you will get 9 and 9. Total could be 18. Y minus y bar whole square, you will get 1 as it is. It is 2. Then go to x minus x bar into y minus y bar. X minus x bar into y minus y bar. You do this into this one. So you will get minus 3. And this into this one, you will get minus 3. Total it is minus 6. This is called as covariance. After calculating this, you calculate return on portfolio by applying the formula return on portfolio. Calculate return on portfolio. Return on portfolio, apply the formula which I have mentioned before, that is wx into x bar whole plus wy into y bar. You apply that. Okay, so weight w of x, how much already we have seen in the weights there, we have already seen the weight there, that is 0.60, 60% x and 40% y. Then the r bar, x bar means here, x bar means rx bar, that is 15 plus weights of y, that is how much? 0.40 into ry bar is 13. So do calculation, how much we'll get. We'll come to know that. So how much you'll get? So you will get 9 here. Okay, so here you will get 5.2. Put together it is 14.2%. 14.2%. Then go to the second one, calculation of standard deviation for x first. Calculate for x, apply the formula, that is root sigma x minus x bar square divided by n minus 1. You apply. Okay. You apply. So x minus x bar whole square. X minus x bar sigma. How much? 18. 18 divided by number of years. How much? 2. 2 minus 1. So how much will get? So you will get 4.24. Same thing you do it for y, that is 2 divided by 1. two minus 1. So you will get 1.41. This is the calculation of standard deviation for x securities and the y securities. Fine. Next, moving on to calculation of r, covariance of x and the y. I'll rub this. Next, find out the covariance of xy. Okay, covariance of xy is equal to the covariance whichever you got, x minus x bar, sigma x minus x bar value, whatever you have considered. You take that one, that is sigma x minus x bar into y minus y bar, whatever value you got it, that you supposed to consider, divided by n minus 1. Fine, that is covariance value. Go back to the table value. So how much you got? You got minus 6 n 2 minus 1. So I will get minus 6. This is called covariance of both x and y. Then find out the r value. Correlation coefficient, correlation coefficient. So how you are going to calculate? Okay, covariance of xy, covariance of xy divided by standard deviation of x and standard deviation of y. That is the formula just before we have written. Okay, so r is equal to minus 6, covariance of xy, just now we got it, then standard deviation of x and standard deviation of y. Put together, so you will get 5.9784. So approximately you will get minus 1. This is the value of r. Fine. So then at the end you calculate calculate ROP, that is standard deviation risk or standard deviation of P. Apply the formula, root formula you apply, weight of 1 square, weight of then standard deviation 2 square, you take that value, you consider that value, whatever you have taken the table, you take it, that is 0.60 weight of x square into standard deviation of x, how much? 4.24 whole square plus weight of x, y, x square 40, weight of x square, then standard deviation 2 square, standard weight of 2 square, then that you are going to consider 0.40 square, then 1.41 whatever you got standard deviation of y, then 2 into r, r value how much? Minus 1 into weight x, how much? 0.60 weight to 0.40 into standard deviation of x, how much? That is 4.24, standard deviation of y 1.41. You take this value, take this value, okay, you will get root. Do it in the calculator. So you will get root 3.92. So 3.9 k, go to calculate the root value. So root value will be 1.98. You will get it. This is the risk factor. This is how we are going to solve the problem on return on portfolio and return on, sorry, risk on portfolio. Thank you.